State of Colorado, Johnny Burt, please. Raise your right hand, please. Swear the testimony you're about to give on the matter of state of Georgia versus Nydia Tisdale is the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God.
I do.
You have a seat, Mr. Burt.
Thank you.
You speak clearly in the microphone, please.
Okay.
Can you state your name?
Johnny Ralph Burt.
All right, and what do you do for a living, Mr. Burt?
I've mainly farmed, but we got an agro-tourism operation.
All right, where's the agro-tourism operation located?
Five Burt's Farm Road, Dawsonville.
All right, and is that also the location of where you mainly farm?
No, we farm in different locations in this county.
All right. Go into the Five Burt's Farm Road location. I want to direct your attention back to August 23rd, 2014. You remember that day?
I do.
Okay. Now, that location, did you host a Republican rally?
Yes, we did.
All right. Who owns that property?
Me and my wife, Kathy Burt.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies from Dawson County?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies to maintain this farm from the city of Dawsonville?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies to maintain the farm from the state of Georgia?
No.
Do you receive any assistance or subsidies from anyone other than your own labor to maintain this farm?
Goodbye.
How long have you owned that farm?
It's been in my family for five generations, but I took control of it in 86.
Before you?
Well, my granddaddy had it, my great granddaddy had it, his daddy had it. You got it. You're in the land lottery.
Okay, now, is Burt's Farm open to the public every day of the year?
No, sir.
Is there times of the year that it is open to the public?
Yes.
When would that be?
September 1st to November 10th.
Now, was that the months of operation that were in place, and August 23rd was under the same operating schedule?
No, sir.
What was the operating schedule back in 2014, you remember?
Same.
Okay, so it was the same. Now, do you recall who contacted you about hosting the rally?
Mr. Beard.
Have you worked out an agreement through Mr. Beard for payment for hosting the rally?
No payment, no.
And did you employ any security for the rally?
Did not.
Was there security present?
There was.
And who was that?
Captain Tony Wooten, the Dawson County Sheriff's Department, sir.
You remember what he was wearing that day?
He's wearing khaki pants and a black, like a polo shirt with a Dawson County emblem on it.
Did you see whether he had a firearm on?
He did.
You see he had a badge on?
He had them on his belt, I believe.
All right, and then on the 23rd of August, did you encounter the defendant in this case, Ms. Tisdale?
Not till August. Broke out, you know.
Okay, but when as you were, and all this broke out, did you encounter her then?
Actually, she was in the barn.
All right. Do you recall what led up to her being in the barn?
I do.
All right, can you relate that to the court, please?
I will.
All right.
Me and my wife, Kathy, were sitting facing the audience on the left, further way down. David Perdue was sitting directly behind us. I've been talking to him a little bit. And, Governor Dale Sander were sitting at the front, kind of in. So a lot of the other speakers were up front. So Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden came over, and I noticed Ms. Tisdale sitting there with the camera. And she was sitting in a position like this. not relaxed, but forward, right close to the speaker. So I called him Clint. He came up to me and him and Mr. Burgess and said that members of the Republican Party were uncomfortable with it.
Let me object to that as hearsay, please.
No, your statements are being testified in court.
It is hearsay because it includes conversations from, quote, members of the Republican Party. It's actually double hearsay.
Tell me that. Yeah, what was told to the person telling him something?
Well, I'm not offering the truth of the matter asserted anyway. I'm asking him based on what Mr. Burt did or what he believed the situation.
I'll allow it only for the
person. Right, I have no idea whether or not these people said that or not. What did they tell you, sir?
They said that some of the members of the Republican Party were uncomfortable in Ms. Tisdale family.
Okay, let's stop right there. This is just Mr. Beard and Mr. Burt.
Correct.
All right, did you talk to anybody else or any other members?
Not at that time.
Okay. Okay, all right. Let's continue.
Okay. And I told Clint, I said, well, just ask her to cut it off. And he said, I already have, and she won't do it. So at that point, we went up, and Captain Wooten was up in the area. If you're facing like the speakers, with the right of the speakers, there's like a little gate there. We go in and out to get the tractors for the hay rides. So he was in that area there, and I told him what's going on. And I said, Tony, would you ask her to cut it off? If she won't cut it off, she'll have to leave. And I requested Captain Wooten to do that.
All right. Now, did Captain Wooten move away from you at this time?
No. I think he turned it. Well, I know he turned and talked to Clint. I went back and sat down. I had to go around to keep from getting in front of her camera and in front of the people. I had to go back around the sort of the back of the audience to, and I didn't sit back down with my wife, Kathy.
Okay. So you, now, did you, were you able to observe what was going on around Ms. Tisdale area?
I didn't really until a lot of screaming and thrashing started. So hollering and thrashing, don't say screaming, but hollering.
All right, so you were describing hollering. What did you observe?
Well, when I first observed it, Tony was standing beside of her, and she abruptly said no, and that got my attention. And I looked, and she started thrashing at him at that time. So Tony looked at me bewildered, like what I didn't know.
Let me object to that, please. Well, that's his characterization of what he saw. With the witness, he described it, how his experiences, it looked like.
He testified to what he saw and what his impression was of what he saw.
And he said it looked bewildered-like.
Well, that's speculation, and I'm going to object to that.
But it's a needless objection, because that's a characterization.
You'll have one cross, but I take it as this witness is impression of what he saw. You
understand? And Tony looked at me and he was like, what I do now? And I said,
same objection. I assume the same ruling, man. Just have a continuing objection, please.
All right. And you did what? That's what I'm
gonna... I did my thumb and I said, get her out of here. And so he proceeded to try to remove her, and she was resisting.
Well, you said she was resisting. What was she doing? Well, I want to talk about what was thrashing. What do you mean by thrashing, Mr. Burt?
She had a camera hearing this and screaming and hollering. Well, yeah, she got to holler no, and he had to take some kind of action, you know.
All right, so now you said he got her up. You see exactly how he got her up?
From my vantage point, I couldn't see his hands right then. We had people between right there.
All right. So, but at some point she's up, right? Why did you witness after that?
She was fighting him, and she was so violent, he had to take her left arm and put it behind her back. She had her camera in his face.
All to fight him. Did she hear swing at him?
When he got right, we got a grain bin there, a corn grain bin that's close to the barn. When he got right there, he had her arm and she tried to hit him with a camera then.
Let me object to that. That she tried to hit him as opposed
she swung at him. I'll rephrase that.
So it calls for a speculation about a mental operation. Did he say what he physically saw, not what she tried?
He corrected that, Judge. So, and just repeat what you said to Mr. Harvey. It was an objection.
Just what you saw.
What you saw.
What I saw.
Yeah.
She swung at him with the camera.
All right. Were you able to watch her exit from the speaking area?
Yes.
Right, we keep referring to the speaking area. Do you have a name for the place where the speaking was doing? What was it?
We call it the gore shed.
The gore shed.
Yeah.
All right.
For reference.
Thank you. All right. But were you able to watch Ms. Tisdale's exit from the gore shed?
I was.
What did you see?
Tony had to forcibly make her go that way with her arm behind her back.
Was she saying anything to you?
Oh, yes, she's screaming, like, identify yourself, who are you? And that's basically it.
Now, did you follow Deputy Wooten and Ms. Tisdale?
Did not, right at that time.
At some point, did you get up to go see what was going on?
After Sam Owens came over and talked to me, I did.
Okay, I don't want to go with what Mr. Owens said.
Okay.
But, all right, so after Mr. Owens spoke with you, did you get up then?
I did.
Okay. What did you do?
I walked in the barn, and she was still hollering and screaming, let me go, and who are you, and all this rehearsed stuff.
Let me object to that. We can strike and ask you to admonish the witness. Please just answer the question.
No, I instruct the judge. Mr. Burt, I know this is hard.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Well, you phrased the word rehearsed.
I'm sorry.
The opinion,
that mean nothing. Okay.
What you may have seen or been impressed.
Okay.
Focus on the is what you saw, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay. Her arm was pinned behind the back from the kennel. She was over the kennel when I went in there. Camera was sort of to her side. She had her hand on it that time, this time. And she was still identify herself, and she screamed out, Capt. Burt, gave me permission to video. And I abruptly said, the owner, Capt. Burt, and I said, well, I'm the owner, and I didn't give you any permission. It's me and my wife on the joint.
Now, where was Deputy Wood position in relation to her this time?
He was over to the side of her.
You were saying to the side of her?
Mm-hmm.
Anytime you see him get directly behind Ms. Tisdale?
Did not.
How long were you in the barn area, Mr. Burt?
3 minutes. Four. Not long.
Was Ms. Tisdale still being restrained?
That's correct.
Now, did you see who they
had
control the camera?
Well, at the time she had her hand on it, she was saying, oh, but it was like this.
Right. She was trying to manipulate or operate the camera?
No, I didn't.
She didn't press any buttons, like if you wouldn't push over, hit any buttons or anything like that?
No.
All right. Now, when you left, do you remember where the camera was?
It was sitting right where it was at when I left, but I was only there a short period of time.
Was it still in Ms. Tisdale's hand?
It was, my wife.
Do you remember who I was in the barn when you left?
My daughter Casey, my son-in-law, Jeff Sanders, and I think one of the politicians had come in there to see what I was doing on one night. I believe it was Secretary of Labor, and I can't remember his name. He came through in there.
Okay. Now, did, you said Ms. Tisdale didn't get your permission. Did anyone approach you to get permission from you to record?
Did not.
Prior to the rally day, did anyone review with you any policies about recording or anything like that from the Republican Party?
No.
Now, did you advertise the rally on your website?
No.
Okay, what about Twitter? Did you have a Twitter account back in 2014?
I've never had a Twitter account.
What about Burt's Farm?
Burt's Farm got one in December the 17th of 2015.
Do you recall whether you signed any documents you were gathering together?
I did not, no. I did.
Did you give anyone permission from the Republican Party to take control of your property for any reason?
No.
You recognize the woman that you saw Deputy Wood restrained in court today?
I'm sorry?
You recognize the lady that Deputy Wood had restrained in your barn today?
Ms. Tisdale.
Good morning, sir. How are you?
Good morning, Mr. Hart.
I understand, Mr. Burt, that you've got a pretty nice place out there on Mr. Burt's Farm Road.
Yes.
And that it's a business that you all run, correct?
That's correct. Mm-hmm.
And during a certain season, it's a tourist attraction, correct?
We call it agro-tourism.
Okay. But you invite tourists and the public to come.
Correct.
And you invite them to come and enjoy the pumpkin farm, the pumpkin, and the things that you make there, correct?
Yeah, we also have agro-tourism.
Okay. And it's a pretty popular place, correct?
I guess.
Well,
yes, it is.
All right. I mean, you know it is, right? It's been around for a while, and everybody knows about it, and you, correct?
That's a matter of opinion, I'd say.
Okay. And what's your opinion?
As to rephrase the question,
well, it's a pretty popular attraction, however you want to denominate it. Everybody in the county knows about it.
Generally,
and they know that you and your family run it and have been running it for a good portion of time. I guess the political parties, like the Republican Party, they want to get a nice venue, and they want to get folks who are known in the community, they call the Burts. You've done it before, correct?
Correct.
And so it's a pretty good venue, would you say, to get folks to come and to hear the speakers and to hear the Republican platform.
Yes.
Okay. And you, the Burt's Farm, has hosted that before, right?
Correct.
Okay. And having hosted it before, when you hosted it before, was it a closed meeting or was it open to the public?
Well, I never did any advertising. I cannot elaborate on that because I don't know how it's advertised.
Well, did you or Burt's Farm have any policies related to behavior or filming or anything like that at the prior rally that you held?
No.
At Burt's Farm, okay. And at the prior rally that you had at Burt's Farm, did the Republican Party take the responsibility for advertising it or promoting it?
That's correct.
Okay. And at the prior event that you hosted. Did you or the Republican Party, to your knowledge, have any policy related to published policy or policy that was announced with regard to filming or picture taking?
Not to my knowledge.
Okay. So the last time that there was a political rally at Burt's Farm, to your knowledge, the public at large was invited, correct?
Correct.
Okay. The Republican Party had no policies that were related to you, and you had no special policies for the Republican event, correct?
As long as everybody behaves. That's what it works.
That's kind of a general.
Yeah.
You know,
if people are on good behavior, we get along.
I get it. But you don't publish something that says as long as you're on good behavior.
Oh no, no. That is common human courtesy.
That's all. Exactly. I get it. It's more on the same page.
Good.
My page has just left.
Sorry.
Yeah, there's not much room on these.
And the prior round, do you remember, Mr. Burt, how many folks were at that prior round?
The one that we're particularly talking about.
No, the one before that. You said you hosted one.
Yes.
You hosted more than one before?
Actually, there's probably two before, okay. Three. Yeah.
All right, let's talk about those two or three, and that's
sure.
I'm just going to work up to.
No, okay, no problem.
At the two or three that you had before,
yeah.
Would all the questions that I just asked you about the policies in the Republican Party and all that kind of stuff, those would hold for each one of those prior events, right?
Yeah, but I don't ever get involved in that.
All right. You don't get involved in the advertising, promotion, internet presence, any of those things, those are all left.
Critter account, nothing.
Sir?
Nothing, yeah, that's correct.
All right. They're all left up to the Republican
great.
Party.
Great, no, that's great.
And generally speaking, you're acting as a facility and a host.
Correct. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm a host, me and one. Yeah.
And that goes back to what I said originally, it's a good place to host an event, and y'all are well-known and well-wanted folks in the community. So it's a good venue, right?
Let's say so, probably.
At those prior events, about how many people do you recollect were present at the
which
prior?
One? Which one?
Any of the three. I mean, just give me a ballpark for you. 50 people, or was there 100 people, or one of them?
Well, we had one with for Kevin Hamilton's. Probably 220 people.
So a lot of folks come.
When the governor announced, we had it depends on whether we serve them a meal or not, Mr. Harvey. People like to eat. And, you know, you have a better, and we didn't have time to cook the meal, so we did the pie thing. So
okay.
The other times we cooked meals and more people came, and, you know, they sit around, talk, enjoy themselves more, and it's sure. More like a...
But there was no restriction, was there, on who could come?
Not my knowledge.
All right. Anybody, to your knowledge, the Republican Party promoted these events, including, hey, come and get the good food at Burt's Farm, but that anybody could come and all were welcome, right?
As far as I know, I never restricted.
And was there any restriction that you knew of, to people either recording what the candidate said or taking pictures of filming or recording the candidate?
Yes, there was that specific day.
No, I'm not talking about that specific day. I'm talking about
previously
times.
To this
yes.
Incident. Okay. No, I didn't.
Okay. Now, in the lead up to this specific day, there were, as far as you understood, the Republican Party, again, was responsible for promoting the event.
Yes, sir. That's correct.
And did you know that they promoted it on the internet?
No, I really wasn't aware of it. No, or I'm so busy that time of year. Somebody else gets our emails. I don't have time to read the paper. I'll just work.
Okay. So here's my question.
Okay.
Do you know whether or not they promoted it or the governor promoted it on the internet or anybody promoted it on the internet?
If I stated that, it'd be hearsay because I've been told and I didn't see it for myself. So,
okay. So the answer, I guess, for back then was no.
Right? Yeah. Okay, correct.
All right.
Yes.
Did you know, or did you see prior to the event any of the advertisements and any other publications like the newspapers or flyers or anything like
no,
that?
No, sir, I just said that I didn't have time to read the paper.
Okay.
Well,
okay. You
got to
ask
that's you that. No, it's okay. I just clarified.
Okay. To your knowledge, just like the other events,
mm-hmm.
the Republican Party promoted, the event was open to the public with no restrictions on who could come, correct?
To my knowledge, yes.
Right. And that was the understanding on August 23rd of 2014, right?
Right.
Now, you didn't have meals, you just had the pumpkin pie, right?
Yeah, we had pumpkin pie and pumpkin roll and drinks and water.
The judge was going to ask you yesterday if you could bring all of us a sample of pumpkin pie, but she didn't.
Mr. Harvey, I'd have been most happy. I would have been most happy and shared it with all of you.
Okay. Now, in these events, people, of course, come at different times, and they kind of mill about the premises.
Correct.
And they walk about and they look at Burt's farm.
Yes. Right? Right.
And they're welcome. Y'all welcome everybody there.
Okay. As long as they behave, they're welcome.
Just like in school, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And people are free to wander around, talk to each other.
Absolutely.
And
yes, sir.
Look at the facility.
Yes, sir.
Now, I didn't understand that there was not any public announcement about any limitation on who could come in, correct?
Yeah, as far as I know, that's exactly what it
was. There wasn't any sign-up sheet. In other words, you didn't have to register or sign up or anything.
Some of the politicians had their own tables there, and
sure.
It wouldn't, like, it's more or less information. It wasn't exactly what you'd say, a check-in sign up, but they did, a lot of people did sign up. For
okay. The politicians individually wanted to get
information for people.
Yeah.
Yes, correct.
Voters information and information about people that might support them and help them in their campaign.
Correct. Yeah, exactly.
But to get into Burt's farm that day, mm-hmm. to get into this political rally,
yeah.
they didn't have to check with you.
No, absolutely not.
They didn't have to get permission.
No.
And they didn't have to get permission from any of the campaigns either. I mean, Governor Beal's people weren't out there checking, hey, do you have an invitation or do you have a registration or you can't get in without paying a...
No, that didn't happen.
Okay. So presumably that anybody who saw the advertisement or anybody that knew about it was welcome to Burt's farm.
Correct.
And I understand that Ms. Tisdale arrived and walked around, and we heard about her conversation with your wife. You weren't present for that conversation.
I was not present.
So whatever conversation was had, you weren't there and really weren't privy to that conversation.
That's correct.
Okay,
that is correct.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when folks came into, and I'm going to say the gourd shed.
That's correct.
Well, because that's what it
well,
is.
Well, we know what, well, I don't know what you're talking about.
Exactly.
Okay, good.
When people first came in, the gourd shed is the location where the speakers were going to speak.
Correct? Yes, sir, that's correct.
And as people were gathering and coming in to the gourd shed,
mm-hmm.
You and your wife were acting as hosts for the event. and greeting folks, right?
Her and Casey were greeting them up front when they were first coming in. I went up to the barn for just a little bit, and I had to leave abruptly on account of some of the seating arrangements. I wasn't up there the whole time. I told my wife and my daughter to stand in for me, that I had stuff I had to do. So me and Clint had to go do some seating changing and courtship.
Now, Clint, he wasn't working for you.
No, he used to, but he's an attorney now.
Right, he used to when he was a kid.
Yeah, he's a good guy, he's a good boy.
But he wasn't working for you that day?
Oh, no, sir, not at all, no.
As far as you understood, did you understand he was sort of helping coordinate with the candidates or the deal folks?
With all the candidates, not necessarily just the deal folks.
He was sort of facilitating what was going on.
Yes, sir, that's correct.
And at the end of the day, he was also an MC. In other words, he introduced the speakers at the beginning.
Yeah, Clint has a good knack talking to a crowd, so I'm not very much of a good speaker. So when we have that, I always say, Clint, would you do this? And my son's a pastor, and we have a prayer before meal. He always does it, so.
Okay. But on that day, Clint wasn't working for you. Clint was helping facilitate everything. He knows you from way back. You asked him to make the announcement.
Absolutely, yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. You did stand, I'm going to go back in time just a bit. Did stand at the beginning, at the entry to the gourd shed for a time.
I wasn't standing, I was moving chairs.
Okay, well, let me see if you can help me here.
Sure.
And maybe if you can look at start you off with defendant's exhibit number 9. Okay. You need any glasses or anything?
Not right now.
Okay. I always need it. That's the gourd shed, right?
No, that's the entrance to the barn.
Okay. Well, I thought you said the. Is that where the candidates were?
At what time?
Is that where the candidates spoke?
At what? No.
Okay.
Absolutely.
Right.
No.
Was that where the meet and greet was?
Yes.
Okay.
That's correct.
Mm-hmm. Now, defendant's exhibit number 9. Are there any signs? I see there are signs about Burt's farm. Are there any signs prohibiting the entry into that location by any people or prohibiting filming or recording or anything like that?
No.
Okay. Now, also, in the meet and greet, you were there for the meet and greet, right?
Like I said a minute ago, just for a little while, and I had to go with Clint. We had to do some seating changing.
Okay, but you were there.
Oh, yes, absolutely, for a little while.
No, that's okay. Let me give you number 10 and number 11.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's when I was there, and David Perdue just came in.
Okay.
And Clint, as you'll see, he's behind back over there. And he came and got me about some of the seat arrangements, and him had to leave and do some rearranging.
But you recognized you.
I did.
There. And you.
Unfortunately, it looks like me.
And your wife also there, correct?
Yes.
All right. Now, have you had the opportunity, Mr. Burt, to see the video?
Just yesterday. I never looked at it till yesterday. Okay. You were playing.
So you've seen it.
Yeah.
So you know that these are stills from the video, and that's the way they've been introduced.
Absolutely.
And David Perdue, or candidate Perdue, had come in and was being filmed by Ms. Tisdale, and she had her camera up.
Okay.
And it looks to me like you're looking directly at her camera filming.
I never saw her camera.
Okay. So
you can't even see my eyes in here. How could you tell that? I can't see them. Of course, I don't have glasses. Your eyes might be better than mine.
And then
I can't see it.
And you can't see it as well on defendant's exhibit 12.
Well, I had some glasses on that. I'll be honest with you, Mr. Harvey, I just, let me warn you, my head's like a watermelon, at least stretchy. No, my eyes are going to turn towards Mr. Purdue. There, you're enlisted tonight. I'll be honest with you, I did not do that for the camera.
So you didn't see anybody holding a camera up?
No, I didn't.
Above there?
No, I didn't.
About, I don't know, 6 or 7 feet away from you, filming the candidate as he came in?
That's right.
Okay. Did anybody come to you at that particular point and ask you about filming?
No.
At this particular point?
No, I didn't.
All right. When the candidates had come in, and then they went, I guess everybody got called over to the board shed, Clint got up and he started, I guess, the speechifying part of it.
Yeah, he sort of trying to get everybody to come in so we could get started.
Did he say, he didn't say his name, do you recall that?
I really don't. I just saw it yesterday and here's the only time.
Well, would you disagree with me if I told you that he didn't say his name?
I can neither agree or disagree.
Okay. If the video shows that, the video shows it, right?
That's right.
Did you hear him? Do you recall hearing him say who he was?
To say for certain, I cannot do that.
Okay. You can't?
No, I can't right off the top of my head.
Did you hear him make any announcements about any policy about filming or videotaping or audio taping?
No.
Okay. Do you know a man named Brian Pritchard?
I don't know him. I've heard of him.
Okay. Did you see Mr. Pritchard there taking pictures?
Did not.
Okay. Or audio taping the candidates?
Did not.
Okay. Did prior to this event, did any candidate come to you, Mr. Burt?
Candidate?
Any candidate come to you and say, for example, I don't want anybody filming me?
Candidate?
Yeah.
Specifically candidate?
Candidate, that was my question.
No.
Okay. Now, I then understood that Ms. Tisdale was, you saw her in front.
Correct. Yes, sir, that's correct.
She was pretty close to the candidates.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And I think you gave us somewhat of a little demonstration. You said she was holding her camera up and out front.
Seated like this.
Mm-hmm. Right, sure.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's correct.
And she was holding it out from her body towards the,
yes,
towards
sir.
The candidate.
Yes, sir.
And it's got
correct.
Kind of a viewfinder on there, on a little screen.
Yeah, that's correct. Okay.
Now, Clint, or Mr. V, got up and started this proceeding going forward and handed the microphone over to the first speaker, correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
And Ms. Tisdale was sitting there recording.
Correct.
Now, at that particular time, you told the state on direct examination where a couple of people were seated. Governor Deal was on the front row too, wasn't he?
Also his wife, Sandra.
Yeah. Governor Deal and his wife
mm-hmm.
were seated on the front row.
Mm-hmm.
They were seated on the front row on the right-hand side. Facing the speakers.
No, it's the left. Oh, facing the speakers. Yes, you're correct. I'm sorry. Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Because Ms. Tisdale was over on the left-hand side. Right?
That's correct.
And Governor Deal and his wife were about, I don't know, within 10 feet of Ms. Tisdale?
Possibly.
Okay. On the front row, correct?
Mm-hmm.
Attorney General Sam Owens was present, correct?
Yes, sir, that's correct.
You would talk with him, right?
Yes, I do.
Okay. Other candidates, Representative Collins, United States Representative Collins,
was Collins there. Yes, sir.
As well as the candidates who were speaking, correct?
Yes, sir.
Now, I think you said that those folks were over on the right. Remember, we're facing the stage.
Right, okay. Yeah, well, to my memory, I know Doug Collins was there because we always have an exchange kidding each other when we were around. So I've had a little exchange with him cutting up. And standing to the right of my pickup, there was Doug. And,
but there was Doug.
There's two or three people with Doug there.
Two or three people there. Standing there, and that was to the right within, again, 10 to 15 feet of Ms. Tisdale with her camera being held.
It's a little further than that because they were up there at the door of the pickup, and the bed's 6 feet long, so you'd add 6 feet to the 10, you're 16 feet then.
Okay. Well, let's say
16. 16, uh-huh, yeah.
Okay. All right, that's fine.
Okay.
Clearly within the visibility range of the front row.
Yes, sir. That's correct, yes.
Now, Ms. Tisdale, she was not asking any questions.
No.
Clearly nobody was asking any questions. Everybody was kind of politely listening.
Yes, sir. That's correct. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
And Ms. Tisdale made no noise while she was filming, did she?
No.
She didn't ask any questions,
correct? No.
She didn't, while she was filming, okay,
mm-hmm.
interrupt anybody?
No.
Okay. So there's no question that she wasn't misbehaving or acting like a school child, like you and I were talking about, right, beforehand?
Not at that time.
Yeah, that's exactly what I was talking about. Okay. Sure. You understand I'm taking it step by step?
Oh, yes, sir. I understand. Yeah.
Now,
absolutely.
She was quietly going about her business at that particular time. Now, I understand there were a couple of people that came, I guess, to talk to you. The first one was a Mr. Burgess, is that right?
No, that's wrong.
Okay.
Him and Clint came, yeah.
Okay, he and Clint.
Yeah, that's correct.
Okay. And as a result of Clint and Mr. Burgess coming to you, she was close to the speakers, she had a camera, and was it someone from the Republican Party that requested that she stopped filming?
What I was told, it was some of the Republican candidates were, it made them really nervous.
Okay. And that's what you were told by Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden?
I believe Mr. Burgess was doing the talking at the time.
Okay. Now, you said to whom? Well, let's ask her to leave.
No, I didn't say that. cut the camera off.
Okay. Now, and who did you say that to?
Clint Bearden and Mac Burgess.
Okay. And did you see both of them go back to talk with Ms. Tisdale?
No, they had already asked her, and they came to me because I was the property owner at that time.
So when you say they, had you seen both Mr. Burgess and Mr. Bearden already go talk to Ms. Tisdale?
I saw them look there. I couldn't hear what they were saying from that point.
My question.
That's fine.
You saw them, both of them, go up there together?
First Mr. Burgess, then Mr. Bearden.
Ah, okay.
Then they both came to me.
Okay.
Well, we're good.
That's fine.
Okay, sure.
I understand you saw Mr. Burgess go talk to Ms. Tisdale first.
Correct.
That was before you talked to Mr. Burgess about this, right?
Yes.
Okay. You then saw Mr. Bearden go, correct?
Correct.
That was before they talked to you.
Correct.
Then after that first, those first two times they came back to talk with you, and then they went back again?
No.
Okay, who went back again?
The next person that talked to was Tony Wooten.
Okay. And did Mr. Wooten, Deputy Wooten at the time?
Yes.
Or investigator, I'm sorry, I don't.
Captain Wooten.
Captain.
Yeah, there you
go. Did Captain Wooten go back by himself?
Well, after I had talked to him, but he talked just a minute. He stood there with Clint and Mac. I don't know whether they're talking or not, but they're standing there. I came back around behind the crowd and seated myself with my wife again in front of Mr. Purdue.
Okay. But did you see Mr. Wooten go off to Ms. Tisdale?
I did.
And did he go up there by himself?
No.
Okay, who did he go up there with?
Well, Clint and Mac Burgess was right there close to him. They were out to the side of it.
Right. So three people went up there?
Yeah, well, they were close. They weren't actually going up to her.
Where was Mr. Beard? Was he behind Ms. Tisdale?
No.
Was he off to the left?
He would have been off to the left.
He certainly wasn't just sitting there behind her when you saw that.
Not at that time, before he had when he went to her.
But he wasn't sitting up there that third time? This is the third time?
No.
Okay.
No.
All right. And Mr. Burgess wasn't sitting there either, right?
No.
So it was Mr. Wooten by himself that actually engaged Ms. Tisdale at that time, correct?
At my instructions. Yes.
And the answer then is yes.
Yes, in my instruction.
Good. Now you can add whatever you want.
Okay.
But here's the question.
Okay.
It was Mr. Wooten that engaged Ms. Tisdale by himself that last time.
Yes.
Okay. You of course couldn't hear that conversation, correct?
That would be correct.
Okay. And where was Mr. Wooten? Was he behind Ms. Tisdale?
No, he was beside her.
He was to the side of her, but behind her, correct?
No. There were chairs behind her. She couldn't get in there.
He was on the front row.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great.
Was Ms. Tisdale still filming?
Not like this. She's like this.
Okay, like that.
Yeah.
That's fine. That's fine. How long did that exchange last?
Not a few seconds she screamed no.
Okay, she screamed no.
Collar no, or what do you know?
Okay.
Real loud, no!
All right. And that would have been right there, correct?
Yes.
Right there while the camera was going, she was still holding the camera.
Yes, that's the truth.
And so we could hear her say loudly, no.
Yes. Right?
Okay. Mm-hmm. Deputy Wooten, I don't know whether you could see, Ms. Tisdale was sitting holding her camera up. How did she get out of her chair? Do you know?
It that time she started thrashing and swinging with her camera knife, and hollering. I could not honestly say.
Okay.
So whether she got up or Tony pulled her up, I think okay. so.
All right. What we do know that she was taken from that particular position back out of the gourd shed, correct?
That is correct.
All right. And
at my instructions.
You can answer all the questions that I don't
sure.
That I don't
that's
ask.
Not a problem. Just
that
ask.
I don't ask.
Okay. No, that's good.
I'm
no
going to ask you just to answer the question that I asked.
Oh, okay. That's fine. Okay. We're good.
And Ms. Tisdale was being taken out of the facility, correct?
Yes, sir.
And she was taken out of the facility by Mr. Wooten, correct?
Correct.
She still had her camera, correct?
Yeah, I don't know how she held on to it, swinging it like that, but she did.
Well, I guess Mr. Wooten wasn't swinging her.
He was guiding her.
Yes. With her arm behind her back?
No, yes,
okay,
yes,
yeah,
that's correct.
That's got it.
He had to.
Because she was saying no.
Right? No, not. Because she was saying no, because she was fighting.
She was
that's
saying,
the truth.
Identify yourself.
Oh, yeah. Okay. Yes, yes, that's true.
Had you heard Mr. Wooten identifying himself to her at any time?
Not my knowledge.
Okay. And Ms. Tisdale, you heard her keep saying, please identify yourself, correct?
Yeah, that's right.
All right. And Mr. Wooten, she wasn't doing anything but being taken somewhere, correct?
No, she was fighting.
She was taken.
That's wrong. She was fighting. Okay.
She was being taken somewhere forcibly, whatever she was doing.
Exactly.
She was taken somewhere
forcibly while she was fighting.
Okay.
Okay.
Now, I guess it was a few minutes before you went from the gourd shed and, can I say, over to the barn? Was it to the barn or the checkout counter?
The checkout counter is inside the barn,
okay.
So you can phrase it every day you like.
Okay. Over to the barn at the checkout counter. The next time that
that's
you
correct.
Saw Miss Tisdale, where she was, I guess, bent over the checkout counter. Is that right?
Yeah, he had a restrainer there.
No.
Okay.
I said the next time you saw Miss Tisdale was when she was bent over the checkout counter. Is that correct?
Correct.
Okay. And when she was, how long did it take between the time she was taken out of the rally to when you saw her at the checkout counter?
I was saying possibly 2.5 to 3 weeks.
Okay. And during that 2.5 to 3 minutes, were you still at the rally?
Oh, yeah, I had no reason to leave.
Okay. Did you hear any screams at the rally?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And so you heard a series of, not just, I'm talking about please identify yourself, but just physical screams. You remember hearing some screams?
Oh, yeah, she disturbed the whole meeting.
Okay.
It was very embarrassing.
Okay.
Very embarrassing.
And one of the candidates, in fact, talked about that. He said, if you've been in politics long enough, you experience everything. You remember hearing that?
No, I really don't.
All right.
But it could have happened, but I don't remember.
Okay. Well, I guess one of the things that could be embarrassing is not allowing the public to film what candidates say in a democracy. Could that be kind of embarrassing?
As long as they behave. You know, everybody has, I have a policy in my place. People don't drink, they don't insult other people, and they behave themselves. Or there's a highway up there that goes two ways. They usually find their way to it.
Okay. So did you have any information that Ms. Tisdale was drinking?
Oh, no.
Or that in any other way was doing anything, we talked about it before this event occurred, that she was just sitting there taping, correct?
Correct, she was taping.
And is there anything embarrassing about, in a democratic and open society, filming a political candidate's speech?
Objection to form. If he's asking his, in your opinion, I don't object.
Okay, in your opinion, comma, in your opinion.
Your Honor, may I elaborate on that question?
You okay. Answer the question, then you can explain your answer.
Okay, ask me the question one more time so I get it down correct. Okay, sorry, Mr. Carter.
That's fine.
Sorry to put you through this.
Yeah. I'll withdraw the question.
Okay.
Now, when you got to the barn, the checkout counter, who was in the checkout counter?
In?
Yeah.
Nobody was in.
I'm sorry. Who was in the who was at the checkout counter in the barn?
And it is referring to.
Well, who are the people there? Who are the people around?
In the barn.
Yes.
Or at the checkout counter. Yes. Which one do you want me to answer? I'm going to answer you more.
Around the checkout counter.
Okay. All right. I got you. I'm with you now. Okay. Okay.
Okay.
Need specifics a little bit. All right. My daughter was standing there.
Okay.
Tony Wooten and Ms. Tisdale at the time.
And did you come in with anybody? Was Clint Beard in there?
No, I met Clint on the way back out. We got like a walkway, and I was going in, he's coming out.
Okay. And was Ms. Humberger there when you were there?
No, I think she'd already left. I'm not sure.
So you don't remember whether she was there or not?
She left.
Was your wife there when you came in?
No, my wife was still seated at the time. I went after I had said, you know, she said Kathy Burt gave me permission. And at the time I said, well, I'm the owner and I didn't give permission, so.
Okay, do you recall when you watched the video what she said was, I'm the owner and I said no?
Yeah, that'd be correct.
So there was no conversation about, I didn't give you permission. What she said was, I'm the owner and I said no, correct?
Yeah, there you go. You got it right there. Okay, thank you.
And at that particular time, when you said that, Ms. Tisdale was already, she was bent over the counter. Either Mr. Wooten, who may have been behind her in the 4 or 5 minutes.
He was not behind her, he was beside her.
4 or 5 minutes where you weren't there.
I wasn't there. But the time I was there, that's all I can testify. You're telling me that he did, and I wasn't there, so I can't answer that question.
Sure. Would you do me a favor and allow me to finish my question?
Absolutely. Yes, sir. I'm sorry. Go ahead. Okay.
There was a 4 or 5 minute period.
Yes,
before you got back to the barn, right?
Oh, yeah, that's great. Okay.
At the time you got there, Ms. Tisdale was bent over the counter. One of her arms was behind her back.
Correct.
And Tony Wooten was standing either to the side of her or but behind her and to the side is what you are telling us.
No, I am not telling you that at all. No, that is wrong. He was standing beside of her.
Okay.
And I was there. Okay?
That's fine.
Yes. Just so you understand.
Correct. She was dead over the counter.
Correct.
A law enforcement officer with a gun had her bent over the counter. Correct.
Correct.
Had her, I guess, secured bent over the counter. Correct.
He had to. Correct.
move to strike, will you just answer the question?
Yeah, yeah. If you ask him straight, I'll answer. Okay.
And tell me what
comment. Now, you know, Mr. Greer will have an opportunity to read your, ask you any questions on redirects.
I apologize, Your Honor.
Just answer the question. If you can explain your answer, feel free to do so.
Okay, yes, ma'am. Apologize.
Ms. Tisdale was bent over the counter.
Correct.
Correct.
Mr. Wooten had her bent over the counter. Correct.
Correct.
Mr. Wooten had at least one of her arms behind her back. Correct.
Correct.
She was at least in a secure position. Correct.
Correct.
Okay. Mr. Wooten, according to you, was to her side. Correct.
Correct.
Which side was he on?
Here. He would have been on the left side.
On the left side, okay. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So would he have had a hold of her left arm, as you remember?
Yes, she had a right one on the camera.
Okay. At that particular time, mm-hmm. that's the time, with all that established,
mm-hmm.
that's the time when you said, I'm the owner, and I said no. Right?
At the time, you mean the exact time, or within so many?
Well,
in general time.
That's the scene
uh-huh.
as you encountered it,
mm-hmm.
when you said, I'm the owner, and I said no.
That didn't. May I ever? That at that time I came in, it was a minute or so of her yelling and all that. And after that, she said, I asked Kathy Burt, gave me permission to film, and that's when I said it. It's
okay.
About probably a minute lapsed.
And that's when you said, I'm the owner, and I said no, okay?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, that's correct.
Mm-hmm. Had you heard Mr. Wooten identify himself at any time?
No.
Had you seen, at least as while you were there, your wife talking with Ms. Tisdale?
No.
Okay. Did your wife come in while you were still there?
No, I went back out then.
Right. Was anybody else there? I think your daughter and just your daughter and Tony Wooten are the only people that were there while you were there. Is that correct?
My son-in-law, Jill Sanders, came in.
And how long was your daughter there?
She was there when I came in and when I left, so I really don't know.
Okay, how about Mr. Sanders? Did he come in while?
He stayed when I went back out to the audience.
Do you know when he came in?
I can't really say the exact time.
Okay. Hold on a second, please. Okay.
Oh, thank you so much.
I think I'll pass the witness at this time, Judge. Thank you.
Anything further, Mr. Greer?
No, Judge. Thank you.
You missed it.
Thank you.